When you think of natural blood sugar regulation, what comes to mind? Most people think of berries, or cinnamon, or spinach. But the humble and delicious Brussels sprout is the underestimated star of blood sugar control. So, I want to show you what's so impressive about Brussels sprouts, the blood sugar crusher you've overlooked. Did you know that Brussels sprouts pack a more powerful punch than berries and cinnamon combined? You're about to learn why this often overlooked veggie is so valuable for anyone concerned about their blood sugar levels. This information is going to change how you think about managing glucose in your body. Before we get down to the nitty-gritty of this cruciferous veggie, please help me grow the channel to better spread the word about real diabetes prevention and sustainable glucose management. So, like, subscribe, and leave me a comment below. Okay, so first off, what are Brussels sprouts? Well, they are small, leafy green vegetables that resemble miniature cabbages. And as a member of the Brassica oleracea cruciferous vegetable family, which also includes broccoli, cauliflower, kale, and cabbage, they are often overfilled with heart-helping and diabetes-fighting antioxidants and other powerful bioactive compounds. I'll tell you all about those in just a sec. Brussels sprouts grow on a tall stalk and are typically harvested in the fall and winter. As for their history, you might think that they come from Brussels, Belgium. And that's correct. Sort of. Brussels sprouts first, well, sprouted up in ancient Rome. But they didn't gain widespread popularity until they were cultivated near Brussels sometime in the 13th century. And that is how they got their name. Growing well in cooler climates, these frost-tolerant plants thrived in Northern Europe during the Middle Ages and eventually made their way to North America in the 1800s. But here was the thing about original varieties of Brussels sprouts. They were quite bitter in taste, and so they never really gained huge worldwide acclaim, at least not until the 1990s. When Dutch scientist Hans van Doorn identified the specific chemicals that gave these veggies that bitter flavor. This allowed Dutch seed companies to crossbreed varieties of Brussels sprouts with the lowest amounts of these chemicals with other high-yield varieties. Soon, Dutch farmers were churning out significant quantities of sweeter-tasting Brussels sprouts, and from there, the popularity of this cruciferous veggie exploded. But here's what hasn't really changed: the amazing nutritional properties of Brussels sprouts. So, let me break them down for you. First off, what is it that you want to get from any fruit or vegetable? If you said fiber, you get a gold star. Now, you might have heard that blueberries are great for blood sugar, largely thanks to their huge helpings of fiber. But guess what? Brussels sprouts take it to a whole other level. Four, in fact. Because a cup of Brussels sprouts contains nearly 4 grams of fiber, compared to just 1 gram in a cup of blueberries. Brussels sprouts give you both soluble and insoluble fiber, including a powerful soluble fiber called pectin. Maybe you've heard of this type of fiber. It's typically associated with apples. But you can gain its benefits from Brussels sprouts too. Pectin forms a gel-like substance in your gut, which helps it slow the digestion of carbs and glucose absorption in the small intestine, leading to more stable blood sugar levels and fewer post-meal glucose spikes. And by binding to bile acids in the gut, pectin forces your liver to use more cholesterol to make new bile. In turn, this process lowers levels of artery-clogging LDL cholesterol. Brussels sprout fiber also helps to feed your beneficial gut bacteria, and that can improve how your body uses insulin. And it can make you feel fuller for longer, which can keep you from mindlessly overeating unhealthy snack foods in between meals. But their excellent amount of fiber is just the beginning. I'm about to get into the huge diabetes-fighting powers contained within tiny Brussels sprouts. But first, I'd like to know, do you enjoy Brussels sprouts? How do you like to prepare and include them in your favorite dishes? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and be sure to click the link in the description below to receive our 3 free diabetes management guides. Alright, now I'd like to tell you all about the blood sugar crushing compounds within Brussels sprouts. Overall, you should know that specific compounds in Brussels sprouts are natural insulin mimetics. This means they act like insulin inside your body, and can help your cells respond better to the insulin your body produces, leading to more stable blood sugar levels throughout the day. One major bioactive compound found within Brussels sprouts is alpha-lipoic acid, or ALA. Alpha-lipoic acid is a powerhouse antioxidant, and it does something really remarkable inside your body. It activates an enzyme called AMPK, which is like a metabolic master switch. This key enzyme is involved in energy metabolism, meaning it directly contributes to better blood sugar control. When AMPK is activated, it makes your cells more sensitive to insulin. This means your body needs less insulin to do the same job of moving glucose out of your bloodstream and into your cells. That's why studies show that the alpha-lipoic acid in Brussels sprouts can work to improve your immediate glucose uptake, as well as your long-term insulin sensitivity. Next, I want to tell you about a unique sulfur compound within Brussels sprouts called glucoraphanin. Well, actually, I want to talk about sulforaphane, because when you chew Brussels sprouts, glucoraphanin is converted into sulforaphane. And sulforaphane is an extremely potent antioxidant and activator of a protein called NRF2. Once this protein is activated, it triggers genes to produce important antioxidant enzymes and other protective proteins. This helps your body combat diabetes-related oxidative stress, and that can work to improve your insulin sensitivity. But wait, there's more. Brussels sprouts also contain a compound called indole-3-carbinol. This is yet another diabetes-fighting compound that has been shown to improve insulin sensitivity in animal studies. It works by reducing inflammation in the liver, a key organ in blood sugar regulation. Plus, Brussels sprouts are a great place to get your camphorol. This antioxidant flavonoid has been found to reduce inflammation in fat cells. That is another crucial component for maintaining insulin sensitivity. So all of these may be compounds you haven't heard much about before, but Brussels sprouts also give you plenty of famous antioxidant vitamins and minerals. So let's talk about their excellent supply of vitamin K. In fact, a cup of Brussels sprouts provides over 100% of your daily vitamin K needs. You may have overlooked this vitamin in the past, but you should know that it plays a crucial role in your blood sugar regulation. Vitamin K is involved in the activation of specific proteins that regulate glucose and insulin activity, thereby helping to improve insulin sensitivity. It also contributes to better insulin sensitivity by reducing diabetes-related chronic low-grade inflammation. Plus, vitamin K helps prevent calcium buildup in your arteries, which can reduce your risk of heart disease. And here's another famous vitamin you might not associate with Brussels sprouts, vitamin C. That's right, a cup of cooked Brussels sprouts gives you over 100% of your daily recommended intake for this celebrated antioxidant. Vitamin C isn't only great for your immunity, it also works to reduce diabetes-related oxidative stress. It helps to improve the strength of blood vessel walls, and studies show it can help to reduce fasting blood sugar levels. Now, let's move on to one very impressive diabetes-fighting mineral within Brussels sprouts, chromium. While Brussels sprouts don't really offer you an enormous supply of this trace mineral, that's okay, because your body only needs it in small amounts. But for all its tininess, chromium still plays an outsized role in blood sugar metabolism. This antioxidant enhances the action of insulin by attaching to cell receptors, thus allowing glucose to enter cells more efficiently. Studies also suggest that getting enough chromium can work to lower fasting blood sugar and HbA1c readings for type 2 diabetics. Plus, chromium may improve your blood lipid profiles by reducing harmful LDL cholesterol, while increasing your levels of artery-cleansing HDL cholesterol. Also, get this, research shows that chromium can be successful in reducing carb and sugar cravings. Actually, many people are deficient in chromium, so adding Brussels sprouts to your diet is an excellent way to boost your intake of this essential trace mineral. Okay, so now that you know all about the incredible array of glucose-stabilizing micronutrients within Brussels sprouts, let's hone in on how you can incorporate them into your regular diabetes-fighting diet. So here's how to prepare Brussels sprouts for the most blood sugar benefits. Now, many people tend to overcook Brussels sprouts, which can lead to an unwanted sulfurous smell and bitter taste. So the key is to lightly steam or roast your Brussels sprouts. This preserves more of their beneficial compounds while also making your taste buds happy. To roast Brussels sprouts, cut them in half, toss with a bit of olive oil, and place them in a preheated oven set at 400 degrees Fahrenheit or 200 Celsius for about 20 to 25 minutes. The slight caramelization which occurs during the roasting not only sweetens their flavor, it actually increases the bioavailability of their helpful compounds. But for an even bigger blood sugar benefit, try eating them raw. Raw Brussels sprouts will give you the highest amount of insulin-aiding glucoraphanin. So, simply shred or grate a few Brussels sprouts into your next salad. But if you are concerned about the taste of Brussels sprouts, here's a pro tip. Pair them with foods high in umami flavor. The bitterness of Brussels sprouts is balanced beautifully by umami-rich foods like aged cheeses, mushrooms, or a splash of balsamic vinegar. This makes them more palatable and can also enhance their blood sugar-lowering effects. If you're looking to maximize the blood sugar benefits of Brussels sprouts, consider eating them before your main meal. This strategy, known as preloading, allows the fiber and useful compounds in Brussels sprouts to start working on your blood sugar before you consume other foods that might cause a spike. For those of you who are really serious about using Brussels sprouts for blood sugar control, consider sprouting them. Sprouted Brussels sprouts have even higher levels of sulforaphane than mature sprouts. You can sprout them at home by placing Brussels sprout seeds in a sprouting tray and rinsing them twice daily for about 3 to 5 days. And now you know, Brussels sprouts are a powerhouse when it comes to blood sugar control. Their unique combination of compounds like alpha-lipoic acid, sulforaphane, fiber, and important vitamins and minerals work together to slow glucose absorption, reduce inflammation, and improve insulin sensitivity. Your blood sugar levels will thank you, and maybe you've just found your new favorite diabetes-fighting veggie.